All right. I am in the shop again today. Connor's working on some headlights and also doing a valve cover gasket on his car, I guess. Over there.
I wanted to show y'all this one cool little trick that my buddy Anton showed me. This dash, basically, I'm having to repair it. It's cracked in a bunch of places, so it's like super floppy. But as you can see right there, you see all that shit everywhere? That's super glue. But one cool thing when you're using super glue is if you get baking soda, you can put the super glue on there and then just go ahead and sprinkle baking soda over it, and it like crystallizes and hardens and turns into almost like this like cement or something. So I'm gonna go ahead and show y'all that real quick. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll go and super glue this sucker. So I'm just trying to get some super glue where it touches on the bottom real quick. Then I'm gonna press it together, and then I'm gonna go ahead and hit it with a good amount of super glue on the top. Gonna super glue that sucker real nice and good. And then grab the baking soda real quick. Boom. There we go. Bam, and it's stuck together now. Now I'm gonna go ahead and flip this over and try to get the other side of it. I got both sides on this piece right here already. Now I'm gonna get the other side of this piece and see how it goes. Look at that. Bam. That easy. So now I'm just gonna look for other little areas I need to repair on that dash. I'm sure there's more of them. Moment has arrived. Connor's about to test the CD for the first time ever. And it's moving. Let's go. I'm excited. I feel like this car is gonna rip with this 6-speed. The gearing was so long last time. Basically, what we are doing, I got the stock dash bar, so I need to cut out this front dash bar from the cage now, and then all of the parts of the cage like that are just kind of sticking up, I need to cut around the welds on all those and get those out, like get that little nub down, cut that out. Same with over here. And then I'm probably gonna grind down all the welds on these plates and try to make them look a little better. Or maybe actually try to take the plate out and then paint those areas red so they don't rust. So yeah, hopefully I can knock this out and then get to start putting the dash bar in, which is right over here. This is gonna be scary. I don't know. I'm not looking forward to that. because I have all the interior bits, like radio, AC controls, everything. And I didn't take any of it apart, so it's gonna be a little difficult, I feel like. But we're just gonna send it. Hopefully testing this car at the end of the month. That was my plan, so. All right, so now that the dash bar's out, I don't think I'm gonna mess with these plates until the steering wheel is mounted up by the dash bar, just because I have this big steering wheel on the way, and I kinda wanna cut these out, so that'll be difficult to get to. But basically, I'm basically just gonna go around and work on like this, work on that over there, wherever the cage comes off that back like strut tower, and try to cut around the welds on those and get those out and clean all this up. And then we'll start getting the dash bar in. All right, so this is actually a huge pain in the ass. Normally when you put cages in, they're never supposed to come back out. So cutting a cage out just sucks, and I never want to have to do it again. There's no point, like, okay. There's no reason to cut a cage out. Like, if you put a cage in a car, it's supposed to die with the car. You don't take the cage out. If it was like a convertible car or something that you could cut the whole thing out and then just like weld it into something else. But even then, like, I don't know. I think whenever cages are put in cars, they're never supposed to come out, but this shit is garbage. So, God, look at that. God, it makes me freaking want to throw up. It's just all globbed together. So with this one, I'm just gonna try to cut it all around as much as I can. And then stick a pry bar in here and just try to freaking yank it and break the rest of the welds that I can't get to. And then hopefully that works. And then I'll clean it up with the grinder like I did this side. That side, honestly, like, it doesn't look that good. It was really, really hard to get that side, but it's better than it was, so. I'm freaking dying. Basically what I've been doing is just hitting. I'm gonna put my tripod on real quick. All right, I've been hitting that, or I mean not hitting it, grinding that down and hammering it as much as I can so that this can just break where the welds are. And then I just use a freaking jack handle. Oh yeah, there we go. And the welds are so shitty, you can just break it off because you can't even get to a lot of places to cut it down there to make it nice. But now it's just held on by the bottom part. Do some circular motion, you know? There we go. And it just broke off through the weld. Sick. Look at that. Nice. All right, that one was a total pain in the ass. That's taking me at least like, this side's taking me multiple hours. But check that out. It literally just broke off of all that globbed on weld all the way around. So now I'm gonna go in with a grinder and basically just grind all this down and then go in with the, I'm gonna go in with a cutter probably and cut as much of the excess as I can first. And then I'll go in with the grinder and grind it all, clean it up. Whew, making progress. I'm getting there. Still not looking all that great, but I got a big glob gone, and then I got this grinded down a ton. I'm probably gonna try to grind this a little more, and then maybe leave this, because I mean, there's not much I can do without taking that plate out. But all right, moving on to the next nasty area.
So I'm just going to cut this out and then grind down all these welds and all this and paint over it. All right, well, it's not amazing, but it's better than it was. I think I'm gonna leave it like that. If I ever do a cage on this thing, I'll probably do new ones, honestly. Cut that sucker out. But, yeah. I don't know. It's better. These welds suck. I grinded them some. But this way, at least, it's not completely trashed like it was. All right. I haven't posted a video in a minute. Just because, like, I've been working on this thing every day pretty much. I kind of stopped filming, doing a lot of this stuff. But basically where we're at right now is I got the cage completely out and grinded everything down. There's no tubes in this sucker left anymore. And I painted over the boxes and everything so it doesn't rust like crazy. And now basically I'm going to take the steering wheel off so I can get this dash bar in there. And once I get the dash bar in, I will bolt the steering wheel up to it and everything. What's up, Groot? You're a good boy, huh? And then start trying to figure out the harness. So that'll be interesting. I'm just gonna wing it. I have no idea. I have no idea how this shit goes together. The harness like plugs in, clips in a whole bunch of spots on this dash bar. But you know, I'll probably end up using zip ties and just kind of leaving it all pretty loose. So whenever I put the radio and AC controls and all that back in, hopefully I can plug them in and then I'll just zip tie everything down. So this dash is also pretty screwed up. Like, it's missing this piece right here where the glove box is. This is broken. There's supposed to be a piece right here. So the dash is pretty screwed up, which sucks. I should have just ordered a whole nother dash with the dash bar online, but I didn't. And that's something I could always do down the road if I want. I just want to get this thing running and going. I have some cool new parts coming for it. So that should be fun. All right, so the dash bar's in. The steering column is hooked up to it. That already looks way better to me, having the stock dash bar there. That's probably where I'm gonna end this video. I'm gonna go ahead and go and just clean up the shop a little bit, like put away some of the tools and like the air hose and stuff that I've been using. Pull all of my interior out. I have a whole bunch of it on the shelf and stuff. Lay it all out so I can have a good look at everything that I have. And then also probably get the table out, lay out all the bolts and hardware that this car came with, so I can have a good look at everything that I have. So whenever I start putting it together, I'm not scrambling and just searching through a whole bunch of stuff. I think it'll save me time in the end. Because I mean, I didn't take this car apart, and I'm sure whenever I lay it all out in the next video and start putting all the interior back together, it's gonna look like a freaking nightmare, I'm sure, honestly. Yeah, I'm sure whenever I lay everything out in the next video, it's gonna look like a nightmare. There's so much stuff. I really wish that I have torn one of these cars apart just so I can kind of know how it goes back together, but I'm just gonna send it. So many plugs and wires, and I got interior up on that shelf up there. Got interior all in the trunk, dash right there. But thanks for watching the video, guys. I'll have another one out in a day or two.